la manikunyuma katikunyuma la kadama. Brothers and sisters in Islam, our community is mourning the loss of one of its members. A young woman who came to this country with desire and hope to make a better life. She was tested like how many of us are tested. Because the human life is subject to trial and to tribulation. As Allah said, Inna khalaqna al-insana min nutfatin amshajin nabtalih faj'alnahu samian basira. The creation of human being, as Allah mentioned earlier, was our ayah. هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا. Allah is reminding us and asking a rhetorical question. That there was time in Allah's creation. Man didn't worth mentioning, let alone to exist. It means among Allah's creatures, in the history of Allah's creations, there were a period where the humankind didn't exist. So we were never mentioned anywhere. Until at which time Allah was said to his angel, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. When Allah said to his angel, I will create vicegerents on earth. I will create a representative to be placed on earth. It's when the human being began to be mentioned. The response of the angels who have limitation was not favorable. And Allah responded, I know the future. I know that which you don't know. So human being was created. And after the creation of the human being, the mention as well, وَلَكَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. Indeed, we have honored the sons of human being. So human being was made with the merciful hands of Allah to be honored, and Allah himself honored human being. Now, if you take away the respect and honor from human being, you will never have peace. Because he was created. And honored by Allah, so therefore, all the misunderstanding, conflict, politically and otherwise, is because of what? Disrespect. So, Allah created us. He said, "Linabtali," so that we can test him. So you'll be tried, you'll be tested. This woman, last week Friday, was killed, was murdered in where she lived. Now, the doer of this act, you ask yourself, what state of mind did he have? Was that an accident? I would say to you, no. It was premeditated. How I want to do it, where, when, because if you respect her like a human being, you will not murder her. Even the pet you have certain level of mercy to the pet you groom in your home. How much more than a human being? She is mother of 3 living children. The younger one is 10 years old. The mother dropped her to school. It will be the only time. Dropping the child to school was farewell. The only time they will ever meet again will be the day of resurrection. Imagine this. How her dream was cut short. This is as a result of domestic violence. And now
it happened.
What happened? We should all hold ourselves responsible. If you heard it, what did you do? Our prophet said, anyone who see or observe wrong, fix it, prevent it with your hand, with your authority. If you can, use your kind word. If you can, then hate that negative outcome. It's the weakest of iman. So today we will pray on this girl and she will rebel. She died in a very brutal way. The irony here is, people from the same community, same religion, religion of Islam. You see the misunderstanding of Islam? Muslim is defined to be the one whom people are saved from the harm of his tongue, the harm of his hand. Muslim is the one people are saved from the harm of your hand and the harm of your tongue. But go to social media and see what's happening in people who claim to be Muslim. See the actions contrary to the true teaching of Islam. So, let us not define Islam by people, but define people by Islam. What is in the Quran and Hadith? The true believer is the one whom people are saved with, their life and their property. They find security with believer. With their life is secure, their property is secure. But if we fall short of this, then Muslim, we have a problem. Women are honorable, as we mentioned, the believer, al-mu'mina. And Allah will give example in the Quran to define believers. Allah said, بِمَنَا تَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى
وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا امرأة فرعون إذ قالت رب ابن لي عندك بيتا في الجنة ونجني من فرعون وعمله ونجني من القوم الظالمين.
The wife of Pharaoh, a tyrant leader, who claimed that he was God, his wife was blessed. You know, when Allah bless, Allah raises, it's a blessing. When Allah raise you, he raise you with the blessing. And Allah also lowers. When he lowers you, that means he leave your affair to your own self. So, when Allah raise you to a higher rank, he build the love of iman in your heart. And he create hate in your heart to disbelief, corruption, and disobedience. So you submit to the word of Allah. This is the elevation. This is the higher level of elevation. That is spiritual elevation. But when Allah lowers you, he prevents your heart from accommodating the love of Allah, the love of his prophet, and the legacy of Prophet. Then you are cursed. So this woman lived with a man who said he was Allah. But she was raised and blessed by Allah. She accepted Moses as her prophet. She accepted the uniqueness, the oneness of Allah. She accepted to submit to the will of Allah. And Pharaoh then said, I will torture you. I will humiliate you. The first thing he did, it resulted to abuse. verbal, physical, emotional. Torture this lady. Humiliated the woman he has made his life with. And then, in her dying moment, in her last breath, she appealed to Allah. She demonstrated the love of Allah, the sincere love of Allah. Rabbi banni indaka baytan fil jannah. Oh my Lord, oh my nurturer, build for me a palace with you, Allah, in paradise. Save and guide me from Pharaoh, his corruption, his transgression, and his disbelief. And the people of Pharaoh. That was what she said. It was her last breath. So the position of women in Islam is honorable. Only an honorable man can honor a woman. Only a fool can dishonor a woman. If women are our mother, our sisters, our aunt, our daughters, our wife, one way or the other. If you are not blessed to have a girl child in your marriage, you have a sister. Or if you have all boy siblings, you have a mother, you have an aunt. What does that show you? Love. So, brothers and sisters in Islam, our conclusion here will be the statistics on domestic violence in the United States are alarming. The problem exists in both Muslim and non-Muslim society as well. The worship of Allah, which Muslims believe is the sole reason for their existence, as Allah said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah said in the Quran, I have not created jinn and man for no other reason except that they worship me. This is election season. Allah don't need your vote. He's an originator. Now when we worship Allah, we worship God, does that add anything to his power? No. So our worship to Allah is benefit to ourselves. We need to understand this. But it adds nothing to Allah. And even if we all refuse, it takes nothing away from Allah. Look at the heaven. It is stated in prophetic narration that the heaven is creaking because of the weight. There's no open space of five fingers, except that you find an angel either in the standing position, worshiping Allah, or in the bowing position, or in prostration, or in sitting. They're worshiping Allah. We don't know when the angels were created. We don't have no historical account of that. They don't eat, they don't sleep. Okay? They don't have the inclination we have to make decisions. But when the angel is dying, when the angels are dying, they will cry. Rabbana ma abadnaka hatta ibadat. Our Lord, we have not been able to worship you in our entire existence as you deserve. But how many of us, some of us came from our native country into the United States. We're Muslim. When we came here, we make a U-turn. We are ashamed to be identified with our true self. At the same time, we want success. How are you thinking then and now? It's reduced to one thing, the lack of knowledge. Knowledge doesn't mean when you go to school and acquire some discipline and training. That's education. It's a raw material. But when you transform it into knowledge to become beneficial, you live by that principle, then you have knowledge. And the container for that knowledge is the intellect God gave you. But if you stay buffling between here and there, you have a problem. Your future is bleak. And some came, they never changed, but they pray every Friday. So if you pray Friday, this Friday, and you die before next Friday, or you die Saturday morning, you go to hell. The difference between Muslim and non-Muslim is the worship of Allah. If you worship Allah your entire life, and you decide to take a vacation, and on your vacation you die, you have disbelief. Think about this. So there's no time off on this business that you were created for. And some say, oh no, all religion belongs to God. We just do it. No, that's a sign of ignorance. Open up your mind to be a medical doctor and to be an army man. It's not the same. We all know. Two different disciplines. So we have to define ourselves. This is a turning moment for many of us. Be who you are, or else your relationship with certain family member. And right here.
وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يُفَصِّلُ بَيْنَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ لَا تَنْفَعُكُمْ أَرْحَامُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يُفَصِّلُ بَيْنَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ.
Your lineage, your blood relation may not benefit you. Your children, the many children you were blessed to have, your relationship with them could end right here. If you don't live on the same principle, you say, La ilaha illallah, they say something else, they will not benefit you on the day of judgment. Your lineage will not be of any benefit to you on the day of judgment. Your relationship will not be of any benefit to you on the day of judgment. The only relationship continues is the relationship based on God consciousness. The religion of submission. On the day of judgment, Allah will separate you. But if your relationship, your lineage, your family remain together in iman with Allah, Allah said, I will reunite you on the day of judgment.
وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ بِإِيمَانٍ أَلْحَقْنَا بِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ وَمَا أَلَتْنَا مِنْهُمْ مِنْ عَمَلِهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ كُلُّ امْرِئٍ بِمَا كَسَبَ رَهِينٌ.
The mother iman mu'min, the father mu'min, believer, they live on this principle. Now they deposit it into their children, and the children practice this. The children becomes the happiness, the comfort of their parents. Then Allah said, I will reunite you in paradise on the day of judgment. But if everybody go their way, then you will go to different cells in hellfire. May Allah prevent that from us. So the reason for our creation, our existence, is to worship Allah. Now if this, then we must be mindful of the right of our neighbor, our friends, our wife upon us. How we live with them and how we interact with them. The kind treatment of others include one's spouse. Can therefore not be ignored.
as an obligatory act of worship, because that is a sign of piety. So brothers and sisters in Islam, we love the sister we are going to bury. Her life was taken broad daylight. To the family, you exercise patience. You exercise endurance. Was it meant for her to die this way? Yes. Was it an accident? No. Now, the matter is in the hands of the law. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, help your brother when he does wrong. Help your brother when wrong is done unto him. Help your brother when he's transgressed upon, or when he transgresses against others. What does that mean?
If you have someone who commit crime like this, help him to become aware that what he has done, this is crime. And it comes to a consequence. But not to help him to deny it, not to help him to play deaf ear to it, no. When your brother, your nephew, your son do wrong, help them to become aware wrong is wrong. And when people take advantage of them, stand beside them to claim their right. This is what Islam tells us.
May Allah make it easy for us. So again, we say to the family, we exercise patience. We don't have to take matters into our hand. Islam don't encourage us to revenge. And if dog commit crime, he's responsible. The Quran said, وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. No soul shall bear the burden of another soul. A dot you plan to do, to take an action. Whatever you did, your mother is not responsible. Your dad is not responsible. None of your family member is responsible. It is your duty, it's your responsibility. But in this period, we know we are mourning. The death of Hawa is a reality. She will never return to us. But to deal with it is the most difficult challenge. Let's deal with it responsibly. Let's deal with it as Muslims. Let's deal with it as people with understanding. So we pray that Allah forgive her and forgive all our dead. Allah makfilah wa rahmahum wa afi wa afanahum wa akhidhu salahum. وادخلوا بالماء والثلج والبرد وناكهم من القطايا والذنوب كما ينكى الثلج الابيض من الدنس وابدلهم دارا خيرا من دارهم واهلا خيرا من اهلهم وازواجا خيرا من ازواجهم وعيزهم عذاب القبر وعذاب النار برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وسلم تسليما. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. أمين.